Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome back, Force here, and today we'll be taking another look at Forge. This is an online multiplayer game that combines the fast-paced action that you see in competitive shooters with the tactical team play that you see in MMOs. Now I took a look at Forge a couple of weeks ago in a first 40 while the game was in beta. Throughout the course of this week, what I'm actually going to be doing is a series of videos, each of which will be taking a look at the character classes within this game. This first video will be taking a look at the Pyromancer. Also, at the end of each video, I'll be letting you guys know what you can do to win yourself some retail Steam keys for the full version of Forge, which is currently available. Let's go ahead and start things off in this first video by looking at the Pyromancer. The Pyromancer is one of the five available classes in this game, and it's basically the RPG equivalent of a mage. Pyromancer is your ranged caster, and this one, obviously Pyro, focuses on fire damage abilities. Now there's a little bit of flavor text here behind the Pyromancer, you can feel free to read that if you like, I don't find it that important. What I'd like to show you guys are the abilities. The first ability here for the Pyromancer is Flame Strike. This is your basic attack done with left mouse button, strikes the enemy with a bolt of flame, doing damage and also gaining resource for you. So actually casting this ability allows you to gain some of your mana back. The next ability here is Engulf. Sets the enemy ablaze, burning and crippling them in the process. This costs mana and does damage over time. This ability right here, Curse of Flame, curses the enemy. The curse can only be lifted by the close proximity of allies. Should they find themselves alone when the curse reaches full power, then they are gravely injured. So this is an ability that if you apply it to a target, if they don't have any friends around, they're going to take massive amounts of damage. However, if they do have allies around, they're taking reduced damage. The next ability here is Flame Burst. This is a burst of flame that allows you to not only knock enemies back but propel yourself a distance away, and when aimed properly this can be a very effective maneuvering tool for getting away from or catching up to targets. Next ability here, Molten Bola. Pyromancer lets loose a bola entangling the enemy and dragging them backward. Also, if it makes contact with any of its allies, they are also entrapped, and then when the bola reaches the maximum distance, it hardens into a temporary cage. So you trap someone in place, pull them back, it can pull multiple targets as well, and then it locks them in place for a short duration. Pretty cool ability. Then we've got Molten Armor. This is a armor of fire around you that if anyone hits you with this, they take damage. I can see the armor releases. Whenever it takes damage, the armor releases to burst into flame to that surrounding enemy. So really good against melee enemies who are up and in your face, such as the Warden or the Assassin. Next ability here is Wall of Flame. This is just a wall of fire that you place on the ground, doing damage to anyone who passes through it. And then lastly, Firestorm. Sort of like the Curse of Flame, the Firestorm, the Pyromancer creates a tempest of flame that attaches to an enemy, following them wherever they go, burning any allies within range. So you cast this on someone, and then all of a sudden they're harming the allies around them. So it's almost like a flip version of the Curse of Flame. Alright, so now that we've taken a look at all of the abilities for the Pyromancer, let's go ahead and look at some gameplay. I do just want to quickly mention I have rebound all of the keys. Normally, by default, the keys in this game are bound to letter keys, but I've rebound everything to number keys just because that's how I prefer to play. Much more reminiscent of MMO gameplay, and that's sort of like how I like to look at this, and again, sort of how I enjoy playing it. I don't know where that guy disappeared to. Oh, there he is. There he is. We're going to take him out without much of an issue. That was nice and easy. Should have gotten the assist on that. All right, so the basic setup is my left mouse button is still my basic attack that returns mana to me. Then 1 and 2, I've got my Engulf Flame. I've got right here the Engulf as well as the Curse of Flame to 1 and 2. Flame Burst is R, Molten Bola is E, C is Molten Armor, 4 Wall of Flame, and then 3 is Firestorm. So that's the layout there for my abilities, just so you guys can know. I'll try to go find someone to kill, huh? There'll be some people over somewhere. There's somebody right there. Hello, how are you? Well, that's not too good. Gonna throw a dot on him as soon as I can. There it is. And then we're gonna lock him in place there with my Bola. And then he's pretty much dead. He is blocking a little bit, but we did get the killing blow. Obviously, we kind of zerged him there a little bit. Now, if you haven't seen already, once again, I have done a first 40 of this game. A few weeks back is when I actually took a look at it. So I cover the basics in the first 40. These videos are more just to highlight the different character classes. This guy won't be a problem. I have not had any problem against the Wardens. I don't know. It just hasn't been much of an issue. So, put our dot on him, and then we get to finish him off right here. And there's the killing blow. All right, let me show you here the little launch that I can do, just what you saw that guy do right there. You can launch yourself up to the high ground if you basically place it right, your positioning in relation to your trajectory. First, though, I'm going to take out this Pathfinder, which is sort of like a archer. Best way to consider him. All right, now let's launch ourselves up here because things are getting a little hairy. So you can see right there, I can launch myself onto the rooftops here, and then I can just fight from a distance, which obviously, as you can imagine, can be incredibly annoying for the non-range characters. However, the non-range characters in this game do have methods of catching up to people, so it's not like I am completely broken up here. People can get up to me. The Warden there, the tank, has this little spin that lets him just fly through the air. And then the Rogue, as you just saw, has got this ability, which sort of like a shadow step is the best way to think of it. Luckily, I can try to get away from him. I ended up dying. Must have been from damage over time. Yeah, I think that's what it was. Oh, well, no big deal. Respawn timer will pop up. So yeah, if you haven't seen the first 40, I can just quickly run over the basics. There are the five classes within this game. Again, we're focusing on the Pyromancer here, and they fill the basic roles. There's a Ranger, there's a Mage, there's a Healer, there's a Tank, and there's a Rogue. And that's basically it. I think that covers all five. Yeah, that sounds like five to me. And you know, you just work with your team. There are different classes, like the Warden's got some abilities that really benefit team play when he's surrounded people. I think he can increase like their armor and resistance or whatever, stuff like that. And obviously the healer's got some team focused stuff. Myself, it's really, I'm kind of self-sufficient. There's nothing significant that I can do for the team, at least as far as I know. Not on the most basic level. And what I mean by that is there is a level up system, like a level progression system, in which you unlock variants of these original abilities. So there will be I've still got the set abilities that I showed the video, that started the video off showing you. But there are different variants of those, so that it sort of like tweaks them a little bit, allowing them to do slightly different things. At the base level, they're still the same, but yeah, they're just gonna be slightly altered. As you level up, you can sort of specialize a little bit. Customize it to your playstyle, I guess, is a good way to look at it. And I am in trouble here. Let me try to jettison out, and I got myself on a roof. And then there's a few heal shrines located throughout every single one of the maps in this game. There's actually two in this little central location, one at this end and one at the other end. Let me move over to the other end to pick up that one as well. So my resource that's being depleted by using abilities, that's also depleted by jumping and sprinting. What I've really found in this game is the smartest thing to do is not jump and sprint as much as possible if you can help it, because all that really does for you is deplete your resources much quicker and make it so that you can't consistently be casting your abilities. So I try to keep my feet flat on the ground as much as possible. It's too bad because in this type of game, like an MMO style of gameplay, a lot of times I like to, I really like to jump, just jump all over the place, even though it provides no tactical advantage. I don't know what it is, it's just a nervous habit, is that what you can call it? Yeah, something like that. So far you've seen pretty much all of my abilities in the works. I've done the launch, I've done the engulf, my 1 and 2, my 3 I haven't done as much. That's going to be good like in a situation like this where those guys are all grouped up, so you can see doing AoE damage now to them. And then you've also seen my Bola, which is, I'll do it right here to this guy, kind of lock him in place. He also can't do anything while he's locked in place like that, so that's another pain in the butt. Let me engulf myself here and then do AoE damage to him when he hits me, and as you saw, I got the kill from that. The one thing I don't think I've shown you yet is the rain of the firewall. You place that and it just goes a short area in front of you. I'm trying to find some place where it actually makes sense to cast it, though. Right now, there's no one around here. So let me place down my firewall. If we can get a large group of people, that would be good. Here we go. We got some guy right here. Place down my firewall there. So if he tried to walk through that, he'd be taking some damage. All right. So we got this guy right here. What is he doing? He's kind of going back. All right. And I'm really not too concerned, to be honest, with these guys. Let me launch myself up here and see if I can get myself to hit them from another angle. The pyromancer craziness. There we go. This guy from over here. I don't think he knows where I am. Does anyone see me? Oh yes, they sure do. I was about to drop down, but then I was like, well, let me check behind me first real quick, just in case someone sees where I am. And they're all coming. So it'd probably be wise for me to jettison on out of here. There we go. Some distance on that, huh? Some distance. Something else that's really cool that you can do in this game, I'll probably just end up repeating it in every video, is this wall jumping. You can jump off the walls like this. It's for one, it's really fun, but it's also pretty hysterical to watch. Alright, so we're gonna try to damage that guy a little bit, but anyone who walks in this line of sight is in trouble. Taking some damage. Get the warden down here. Just throw everything I have at him. I'm gonna try my firewall, see if that lands down there. I'm out of mana right now. Try the firewall beyond him. I can't, can I? No. Yeah, there we go. So I couldn't do it from there. I couldn't do it from that distance. I guess if you're not within range of where you're trying to place it, it's just gonna cancel itself out. Since I'm taking some damage, we're gonna hop back here and run over to the healing shrine. There was a healer over there. I just wasn't, can't guarantee that he's gonna heal me, so I'm gonna rely. Although he does have this little AoE heal thing going here now. And let me drop the wall. Perfect spot for it. Look at this. Oh yeah. Burn, baby. Burn, burn, burn. Come on, there. Finish him off. It's a good game. Going very well. Looks like we've got an organized team. A little duel over here. It's not going to be much of a challenge, though, once another man enters this arena. That man is me. That man is Force. And cohort is assist. When you receive the cohort buff, it just means that you've assisted. So yes, the leveling system in this game, again, this is probably something I'm going to mention every video since I'm doing a series of these, looking at all five. But you unlock XP through these matches. This is a multiplayer only game, so there's not anything beyond what you're seeing. There's different maps and stuff and different modes. It's like a deathmatch, sort of King of the Hill, which is sort of like what we're playing right now. And yeah, so that's this. There's these varying modes, but it's still, it's the same game. And as you play through it, and you perform well, you get XP, and then you use that XP in a level up system to unlock the item variants that I mentioned, as well as, let's lock this guy in place here. There you go, you're in trouble. As well as a variant, you can sort of tweak your character a bit. So what happens is there's these attribute points that you acquire as you level, and you can use them to disperse between armor, speed, and resource. So you basically take away from one to add to another is how it works. So that allows for customization. So if you want less armor and more resource, or less armor and more speed, you can do that. Or of course you can have less resource and more armor, or you know what I mean? It's just as the, obviously I'm just gonna, I could keep saying all of them, but you take away from one of those three things to add to another. And then you also have extra armor that you get throughout. I think there's various character skins that you can acquire, and there was something else that you get when you level up. The varying abilities, so slight variations onto the normal abilities. So this guy's trying to attack me. I don't know what he's really thinking, to be honest. Although there's someone behind me right now hitting me. I'll try to stay away from that. And both these guys acting funny, so I'm just gonna launch myself up into the air. I don't know that I've died. Yes, I have. I died. What am I talking about? Oh, come on, you silly little Kojinito? How do you... Is that right? Am I pronounce that correctly? This jerk. Ugh. Shoot. Two of them over there. Gonna bit outnumbered over here. Let me launch myself up there. Some shenanigans going on up here. Set him on fire. And then kill. And so you can see the distance that I can get. I mean, I can hit people from literally like all the way across the screen. If you can see them and they're in your line of sight, you can hit them. Okay. He's got one up on me there because I am low on health. Of course, I've got the advantage of skill, but you know. All right, then we got some guy up there, and I'm blinded. That is an ability from the Pathfinder, the Archer. Come on, get the killing blow of that guy. He's at like one health, please. Thank you. Oh no. Get away from him. Heal myself up. Okay. Well, things are looking mighty good. And the teams aren't even, and we'll be auto-balanced. That's unfortunate. Well, you know what? I think beyond that, though, how are we doing right here? Oh, doing pretty well. Second place on the team? All right, I'll take it. So that's actually going to wrap up this video. I'm not going to go through the entirety. You know what? There's just a couple of minutes left, so let's just finish this off. Just wanted to show you guys, you know, about 10 or 15 minutes of gameplay, and because I am going to be doing one of these videos for each of the classes, I didn't want to draw these out too long for that reason. I just want to make sure that we're going to be able to, you know, reasonably get these videos done this week. I would like to try to do about one a day for each of these classes. That's going to be my game plan. So, oh darn it, I'm in trouble, taking some damage. And okay, we're good. We're good. This last guy over here. Jerk. Watch, I'm gonna die in like the last second. Although I did just get the Survivor Medal for more XP, so that's awesome. I've got 40 health. Are you kidding me? I should be dead a long time ago. This guy's trying all sorts of shenanigans. Look at him. He's trying to... Did you guys see that? That was really funny. He knows I'm at low health. He's trying to kill me. How rude. All right. That is gonna finish it off. We got about 40 seconds left in this particular match. So thanks for watching, guys, as we take a look here at the Pyromancer again. Stay tuned in the next coming up days for additional videos looking at the other character classes in this game. You know, I've mentioned in the past, in the first 40 that I did, I think this game's pretty fun. I think it's a unique thing. It's a unique experience. Having that mix of elements for a fast-paced, competitive shooter style of play with, oh my lord, it's like a free kill. Mixing that with the MMO style RPG character classes and stuff like that, I think it's pretty neat. I really enjoy it. And as we wrap up this video, I'll let you guys know how you can win some retail keys. So what we're going to be doing is giving away 4 retail Steam keys for Forge throughout the course of this series. There are going to be 5 videos total, and in each video I'll be giving away 4 keys for Forge. In order to win, all you need to do is find the secret word that flashed halfway through this video, which if you watched the whole thing, you should have seen, and then post that in the thread that will be linked below. Of course, this is going to require you to be registered for our forums, so if you happen to miss it this time, register anyways so that in the upcoming videos, you'll have a greater chance of actually winning a key. So once again, find the secret word that flashed halfway through this video, follow the link below which will lead you to our forums, and then put a post there, and if you're one of the first 4 people to post that secret word, then you're going to win a retail key of Steam on Steam for Forge. Alright guys, thanks so much for watching this look at the Pyromancer Forge. Stay tuned later in the week for the additional videos and more chances to win. Thanks again guys, keep watching and keep owning.